How many of you back when you were in grade school, or this little meeting, and someone said something to you back in the first grade, second grade, third grade, whatever it might have been, and you never, they said something hurtful to you, and you never forgot it to this day?
This kid was sitting there alone. Everybody else was sitting with something. Breaks my heart. Because there's not one of you in this room that would want to be the person sitting alone. It's the most lonely feeling in the entire world. All you're hoping for is that someone will come by and say some kind word to you. All you're hoping for is that someone will come by and pat you on the back. All you're hoping is someone will come by and invite you to their table. All you're doing is hoping that someone will come and sit with you. It's the worst feeling. So I walked in and I saw this kid sitting alone. And I said, man, I said, there's a bunch of us eating over here. We can come eat with us. And he just sat in his chair and just shook his head. No, he moved and looked up at me. Because he's scared. This is a man who was scared because he lived on every single day. And then I later found out from the principal that some people thought it was funny, right? Ha ha, funny. Real men, real women, right?
No, not at all.
To be able to take Snapchat and take some videos of this guy when he wasn't looking and say some of the most horrible, degrading things you can ever say to another man. No wonder he was scared. And he did me a favor, will you come eat with us over there? And he just still shook his head no. I could have ate with him, but I wanted him to meet some friends. That's why I wanted to encourage him to go over there. So I thought, he's not going with me, I'm going to make him go with me. And here's how I did. I picked him up in his chair with him in it, and I put him over my shoulders. I picked him up in his chair with him in it. And I brought that boy over to that table, and I put that sucker down, and I said, man, here are your new friends. And I introduced them to everybody at that table. See, I talked to that table ahead of time. The table that I sat next to, or with, was a group of the so-called most popular kids in the whole school. And I asked them if they would help me out with this. I said, will you do me a favor? Will you look out for this guy? You're in school and out of school. Every chance you get, look out for this guy. And they said, yeah. So much so, that principal said, at the end of the school year, Tom, that's changed that kid's life forever. He's a totally different kid.
Young people, everybody repeat after me and say truth. There's another truth. The truth is, real men and real women know how to treat another human being. And you can be a real man and a real woman in 6th grade, 7th grade, and 8th grade. Because real men and real women know how to have respect, and they know how to treat other people with respect. That's a real man and a real woman.
I'm here in Runnymede, New Jersey, and I got these awesome students behind me. Everybody say what's up? That's a cool, cool group right there. Front row, my front row students.
Did you enjoy the assembly?
Yeah!
What was your favorite part?
And we probably are talking about like the people.
This high school had a lot of problems.
Yeah. What's in your skinny jeans?
What?
Awesome.
Like people start fighting. Like,
go make a difference, right?
Yeah!
Sweet.